In the past few videos, we've been going over the theory and examples of how to solve linear systems of equations using Gauss elimination. In this video, we are going to walk through how to implement the Gauss or Gaussian elimination into your Python codes with partial pivoting. Let's go through a quick reminder of what Gauss elimination is and how it works before we begin going through the code side. Gauss elimination is the process of transforming a square system of linear equations into one of our special matrices, specifically an upper triangular matrix. Meaning, we take our square linear systems of equations, we perform Gauss elimination on them, which then allows us to easily solve the matrix. Briefly, this process is started by transforming our matrix into an augmented matrix. Then, we sequentially row by row reduce to zero all the elements below our main diagonal. This is accomplished through the following scaling factor formula, which is demonstrated in our Gauss elimination example videos, for which I will leave a link in the description down below. Then, once our matrix is in the upper triangular configuration, we perform backward substitution, which means we begin at the bottom of our matrix and solve for unknown variables row by row, moving up the upper triangular matrix. Now that we have a broad understanding of how Gauss elimination works, let's get into coding Gauss elimination in Python. To do this, we're going to use the NumPy library, as it allows us to work with matrices easily within Python. In the IDE that I'm using, PyCharm, to import NumPy, I like to do it in the following manner. I will click on the interpreter in the bottom right-hand corner of my screen and click on Interpreter Settings. This will bring you to the following Package Manager screen. Here we can find this small white plus button and click that. We're going to search for the NumPy library and then click Install Package. It is very important during this stage that you install NumPy to the correct interpreter, or else Python will not recognize the library when you try to run your code later in this video. Now that all the packages that we need are installed correctly, let's begin coding Gauss elimination. I'm going to define this as a function. The function parameters we want our user to give will be an A matrix, which will be our linear system's coefficients, and a B or constant matrix. Next, I'm just going to add some contingencies so that our user can know what they've entered incorrectly rather than them just guessing. I'm going to break this up into two parts. The first of which will check if our matrix is entered correctly. And the second part will ensure that our B matrix works with our A matrix and that it is sized correctly. Our first contingency will use the shape attribute, which will allow us to get the row and column dimensions for our arrays. So we'll first check if our A matrix that we are given is a square, as it should be. Or if it is not, we will return an error to our user and let them know their mistake. And as this will cause problems in the future, we are just going to put a return here. This will tell Python to return to the portion of the code where this Gauss elimination function was called, as we don't want Python to continue the algorithm if our matrices are sized incorrectly. Secondly, we need the rows of our constant vector to equal the rows of our coefficient matrix to properly form our augmented matrix. Additionally, we need to ensure that our constant vector is only a single column. You can read this line as if B matrix has more than one column we return. In our 2D matrices, think of 0 here in our shape attribute as a row and a 1 as our column. Secondly, we say if our B rows do not equal the rows of our matrix. Moving forward, let's add a few lines to initialize some necessary variables. Firstly, we are just going to take the length of our B matrix, which is the same as column shape attribute we used earlier. let's add in a variable that is one less than our length. And I'm going to add in a few iteration variables that we will use soon. Then, I will just initialize our solution vector, our x vector, using our zero function of size n rows, and one column. Lastly, I'm just going to make a string variable that we will call later in our function. Next, let's complete the first step of Gauss elimination, which is creating our augmented matrix. I'm going to do this through creating a new matrix that concatenates, or adds, our B matrix to our A matrix. This will be done through NumPy's concatenate function. So, we call our two matrices, and then tell it that we want to add the B matrix in the column direction, hence the x equals 1. Lastly, I'm just going to make this matrix a float data type, as an integer-only matrix could cause some inaccurate calculations to occur due to truncation error. I'm also just going to add these two print statements that show our user our beginning augmented matrix and shows that we are now beginning to solve the matrix through Gauss elimination. And although semi-unnecessary, I like visualizing my code like this, and if you're like me, it allows more proper understanding of the code and identify where any errors could occur. Now, our Gauss elimination will be completed under this while loop. We say that while I, which is an iterating variable, is less than n, our number of rows, we run the code within the while loop. Now, I'm going to add in our partial pivoting step. To do this, I'm going to use our iterating variable, p, in the range of I plus 1 to n. We want it to be I plus 1, as we don't want our partial pivoting to check above our main diagonal. Then, we say if the absolute of our main diagonal element is lower than any element below our main diagonal for that column, then we are going to swap the rows. And that is what the second line here does. Next, even if after partial pivoting, you still have a zero in your main diagonal, we are going to run into issues with our scaling factor formula. Therefore, let's add in a print error and return like we did previously. Assuming we have no zeros on the diagonal, let's begin going row by row and systematically convert all elements below our main diagonals to zero. So, this if statement is saying, while our iterating variable j, which is currently I plus 1, up to our number of rows, n, complete the row by row reductions. Then, we need to increase our iteration counter, I. And we are done with the Gauss elimination row augmentation. Our final step of Gauss elimination, we just need to complete backwards substitution, starting with our last row of our augmented matrix and working our way up. We begin by initializing our backwards substitution by solving for our first x value. We use n minus 1 here as our value of m. So, we only need to divide our bottom rightmost element, so m rows and n columns, since our augmented matrix is going to be one column longer, by our xm value at the bottom of our matrix. This solves for the bottom value of our x matrix. Lastly, let's begin the backward substitution algorithm, which works by beginning at our second last row, since we have just previously solved for the bottom row. This range function will begin at n minus 2, so our second to last row, and move up our matrix rows by taking minus 1 steps, meaning we are going up our matrix, with each iteration up to minus 1, as range does not include the end step. So, a 0 here would ignore our last row. Lastly, this line here will go through and complete the relevant element by element algebra. Let's now display the result to our user. I'm going to do this in a for statement as I think it looks nicer. I will say, for temporary variable, answer, within our range of n, and in this first curly bracket here, simply count up. And in the second one, it calls the appropriate x value for our vector. As you can see, when I run this example, we get the correct answer out. However, if I remove the partial pivoting step, we now get an error. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to implement Gauss elimination with partial pivoting in Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.